western guns travel towards eastern sands. Father of earth, their goals, a pledge for creation's soul.
And why it's here at DART. And basically, I've been competing in memory competitions in the US for almost 7 years. And you know, I started back then because of my grandmother who had Alzheimer's disease. And that's something that was obviously very moving to me. And I started getting into memory and how could I improve my brain health. And that led me to find out about these competitions that exist around the world where people were training their memories from average to be able to memorize a deck of cards or a series of numbers really quickly, something that I could not do and didn't think that I had the capacity to do either. So I investigated, I learned the techniques, and very quickly I was able to do some of these feats, and I started competing in these memory competitions and very shortly became one of the best ones in the US. Along that process, I managed to get in contact with Washington University in St. Louis. I believe they were doing a study on people who have trained their memories and running them through a bunch of different memory tests and comparing them to other people who didn't train their memories. And so I participated in this 2-day study. They threw a bunch of tests at me. And you know, all this time I had also thought of ideas where we could make memory a little more exciting to watch. If you've ever been to the US Championship or the World Championship, you'll find that it's something that's very interesting and fascinating and crazy to watch, seeing the volume of information that some of these competitors can memorize. But it lacks something that makes it audience friendly. It looks a lot like people taking tests. And while for us competing, it's great. And while for an academic crowd, it's very interesting to watch, it doesn't really draw people in. And with spelling bees and hot dog eating contests, you'd expect that something like memory, which is something we all use and could improve, should be as popular, if not more. So we talked with the people at Washington University, and they mentioned that DART was funding a lot of their research. So we decided to put together a pitch, and we kind of brainstormed and had some ideas of a competition that was kind of like a tennis match, one-on-one, and all digital. And they really liked the idea and said that they were opening up a new facility where you are right now, and that it would kind of time very nicely if we held this XMT or whatever it was called, going to be called, here in that location. So after many, many, many months of meeting with the folks at DART, Washington University, I pulled in a guy from Australia who's an Australian memory champ, or was a former one. He's a coder. He put together all this fantastic software. And last year we had our first event, which we had a great response to, and here we are for the second time again. So that's where the Extreme Memory Tournament comes from. The idea, and I still feel like there's a lot of room to grow, but I think we're kind of on the right track, is to make this competition something that's it's really exciting, that people want to watch. And we've had tons of people watching online, which is great too, and maybe that's a big part of the future of the sport as well when it becomes completely digital, is to just be able to watch it from anywhere. And this thing streams and people can see everything that is going on in these people's heads when they're memorizing. So we'll see where this goes next year. I know you guys all RSVP'd and gave us your email, so we'll send you out probably a questionnaire. We'd love to get your feedback on how we can make this more exciting, better, what didn't work, what you thought was the best, and so on. So a lot of you are competitors and you know how this works, but some of you may not know how the heck these guys are doing that, right? Believe it or not, all of these people are trained. This is something that they could not do at one point, like I couldn't either. And they trained their minds using memory techniques and a lot of dedication and practice. And the techniques that they use are techniques that are ancient, used by the Greeks from thousands of years ago. And it basically takes advantage of two things that our brains are very good at. One, which is visualization, thinking in pictures, and two, spatial information. So let's take a deck of cards, for example. You know, most people, if I gave them a deck of cards, just with raw memory, they could probably only do maybe 5 cards. It gets very overwhelming very quickly with the suit, the number, and 52 is a lot. And they get very similar after a while. People can't do that naturally. So the techniques that they use is they'll give each card a picture. And that takes advantage of this visualization that I mentioned, that people remember things that are pictures. That's how our brains work. So if we can turn the things that are complicated into pictures, we can remember them better. So a lot of these competitors will sit down or have sit down and given each card or each pair of card, which takes a lot more work, a specific image that they see every time they see that card or pair of cards. That way it's almost like a language. It's just like looking at a picture of something rather than this abstract piece of information. Now what do they do with that picture? They take that picture or that series of pictures, right, for the deck of cards, and they'll place it in a thing called a memory palace, which is a mental visualization of a space that you know very well. So a common place and a good example is to talk about your house, which you know very well because you live there, right? You can walk from your front door all the way through it and make your way out to the balcony or whatever in your bedroom. You'd walk through the door, you can picture that, there's the hallway, maybe there's some rooms, you go to the kitchen, the living room, and so forth. We can all do that very well. The idea is that since you know that plan very well, you can place these pictures that represent the cards, or you can imagine them along a path through that place. And that knowledge, that memory that you naturally have of that space, because you're always there, will preserve the order of the things, the images that you memorized, that you're thinking about. And when you want to recall them, all you do is mentally navigate through that space again, and there will be the images, which you then translate back to the cards. So then it becomes kind of two things. How do I turn this abstract stuff, cards, numbers, names, into pictures, right? That's a strategy that you have to figure out. How do I do that? And secondly, where am I going to store it? Should I put it in my house? Should I put it in the grocery store? And a lot of these competitors have an encyclopedia of memory palaces that they'll cycle through and that they'll use. He's doing cards, he'll use his house, or then he has to memorize numbers, he'll use his walkway through his favorite city, and so on. And it sounds very complicated, but it's something that we all can do, and this is proof. Not one of these guys had this naturally. This is something we've all worked on. And there are plenty of resources out there. Brad is selling his book. He has a great book for children on how to do this. Boris is also selling his book, but I believe it's in German. So if you speak German, that's good. Another great book, Roddy's selling his book too. I don't know if you brought any. Didn't, okay, but you can get it on Amazon. It's called Make It Stick, right? Got it right. Roddy is from Washington University, as I was mentioning. That's kind of where this all started, and he was a big part of that process. So without further ado, we're going to get into the third place runner-up match, and then we'll finish with the finals. So we're going to start with a surprise task. I promise it will be better explained. And The one that they're going to do first here for the runner-up match will be the same as the first one for the finals. So if we can call in, actually, Alex and Simon. Simon's in the back. winner will be third place. But also, third place will win $5,000. Fourth place will win $3,000. Okay, sure. So most of the events in memory competitions and surprise events that I've done in the past have been visual or auditory, and this is the case in other memory competitions too, but we've never really tested other senses. So we're going to try that today with touch, okay? So what we have is, and Brad will bring in a sample of what it will look like. We won't show you exactly, but we'll give you an idea. But you'll be blindfolded, okay, and given a minute to feel and memorize the order of textures, okay, on a board. We've placed them on a board that's about yay big, and you'll get to see that board. And there are 22 different textures in a row from left to right, which you'll be able to feel. Yeah, you can bring that. So you'll see there's some markers that indicates five. There'll be five spread out. Every marker, there's five, 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 and then two at the end. There's actually 22 textures. Okay?
When you feel, that'll be five, 20.
Yeah. And to be clear, they're all distinct. They may feel somewhat similar, maybe not, depends on what you think, but they are all different things. Just so you know that. And what else can I tell you? They're as high as the board, but maybe 2 inches thick each, right? So we're fitting 22 in that board.
There's five within this. There's two within this, so you can see how wide they are.
You'll be able to feel that you're onto another texture. So we will blindfold you and place the board in front of you. We'll guide you and give you a sense of where your hands should be so you can start. You can feel the outsides.
That'll be the left. The 20 and 2 will be on the right.
And then we will tell you when the minute starts, we will tell you when it finishes, and we can decide on what kind of warnings you want, maybe 50 seconds, I don't know, you'll tell me. And once that minute is done, you'll flip around and you'll have all the textures loose that were on the board, and you have to place them in order, and you can take off your blindfold, okay? So the recall is visual or touch. I mean, you can close your eyes and feel, but you can also see everything. Otherwise, it would be very difficult.
Scoring.
Scoring will be...
This is important.
Scoring will be every correctly placed is plus one. So you get a point for every correctly placed texture. No penalty for errors or for guessing.
And you have to make clear where each one is. It's up to you to make clear to us so that when we go, okay, that's obviously number one, two, three, four, five. So if you, since there's no penalty for guessing, there really shouldn't be any gaps.
Yeah. And you can think about it like when you guys lay out a real deck of cards in order, just leave it like that in order. So we'll score it from where what the most leftmost texture is to the right on your table, right? Okay, any questions?
Yeah. Timing, and are we allowed to watch, or do we have to
leave? I'm going to ask you guys to leave when they're actually doing it, okay? Just so you don't see what it is. Yeah, it's 1 minute to feel, and then 4 minutes to put it back together.
So, did you say there were...
I'm sorry. It's 2 minutes. We're giving you 2 minutes. Yeah. 2 minutes to memorize, to feel, and 4 to recall.
We need a 2-minute clock up.
No, I mean, we'll tell them. They can't see, so.
22
textures. And before, when you're blindfolded and we're about to start, we'll take your hand so you know exactly the limits of the board. And maybe you can start your hands there if you want. But on the sides, not on top, so you don't feel the first texture. Yeah. So I'll say 3, 2, 1, go. And then what do you want?
After 1 minute and when there are only 10 seconds left. So after 1 minute and after 1:50.
Okay, so you don't want me to say anything in the minute.
Could you do, maybe
1 minute and 1:30 or so.
1 minute, 1:30, 1:50.
Okay, so 1 minute, 1:30.
And 1:50.
Yeah. And 1:50? Okay, so with 10 seconds left. I'll just count. How's that? I mean, you'll have to listen, right?
4 minutes recall.
Yeah.
And we have to use all of the 22 during recall. So you said there are
gaps. There are 22. I mean, you can leave a gap, but make it clear that there's a gap. But you might as well guess, right?
If you're, what time is 4 minutes?
4 minutes. Yeah.
But if we just like space them out, you can tell.
Yeah, we have...
The recall pieces are twice as large as the memorization pieces.
It's a square, a little square.
If you can picture 22 on here, it'll be twice this if you space them all out. So you may want to consider doing like a deck of cards where they somewhat overlap, as long as it's obvious and clear that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
But they're uniformly the same thing that you felt. It's from the same... thing,
during
texture.
Memorization, they are fixed on the board.
Yes. Yes, they're fixed, so you can rub across it and it won't shift.
There is either a little bit of double-sided tape or a spot of glue that shouldn't interfere with the texture. The texture should be very clear without like a bump of tape or something.
Yes, Florian.
Are we allowed to take pictures? Because the finalists technically could see them on social media.
Yeah, you won't, is this, where are you going
to
take them?
Go to the
hallway
back.
Okay.
So, question, you said the left side of the desk, is that for each player's left? Or is that the left is fine? I just want to make sure it's fine.
Yeah, no, the player's left. So then when they turn, they're going to be starting from there, which was the same as their left-hand side there. It's just mirrored. Oh, I know, you can start, yeah, they can start any side you want.
As long as number 22 is in 22, and as long as it's clear. So 2 minutes for them to think about
yep,
it?
Yep, we'll give you 2 minutes starting
and we need them
now.
Or they can think about it.
They can do that, yeah. It's a full 2 minutes.
And they can't just premature.
No, yeah. Okay, so I just need you guys to tell me that you're both ready, and we'll.
Ready.
Okay. Brad, will you do the 2 minutes? And we'll warn you at 1:30, 1:30, and...
Is there going to be a countdown?
I'll give you a countdown.
I'll do it. I'll hit the buttons.
Brad will give you a 3-second countdown.
Well, ready? Your time starts in 3, 2, 1, go.
You can turn around immediately.
Keep your mask on, please, for a moment.
All right. Will you time that? All right, you guys ready? Recall, 4 minutes.
Your recall time starts in 3, 2, 1. You may remove your masks.
Two minutes remaining. 1 minute remaining. Please make sure your gaps are obvious or fill them in with something. Seconds. Time's up. Please remove your hands from the table. Thank you.
So it's like one.
And then next row?
Again.
Okay, cool. Do you want to score?
Okay.
You can score that one. So you're starting from that side, yeah? Tricky.
Right, so, it is one.
So one.
I'm going to wait for Nelson to score. Betsy, you want to help Nelson score and then Nelson can help.
All right, so one.
One, right?
Two, that's correct. Three, that's correct. Four, that's correct. Double check. One, two, three, four. Yeah, four.
And this one is better, so.
Okay, yeah.
Count 10, but I've counted a different amount twice.
Correct, so, because you have three and you have
so
four.
So one, two, three, four, five.
Skip.
Six.
Skip. Skip.
Seven.
Skip.
Eight.
Skip. 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 Skip.
Nine.
Skip. Skip.
Okay. Yeah. Nice. So Simone wins with 9 over Alex 4. Well done. That's really difficult.
After the last event where the next competitors get to try, these will be available outside in the lobby if you want to test yourselves.
It's harder than it looks. I mean, and it looks hard, so. Yeah, a couple of minutes and then be back.
See you in a bit.
Yeah, just a couple of minutes if you want. Okay.
Thank you.
Just be a couple of minutes and then we'll continue.
Roger and maybe. Thank you.
Competitors are ready. Pre-memorization starts now. Thank you. Simon takes that match, 35.17 seconds over Alex, 60 seconds. Simon goes up 2-0. And Simon, you can choose the next match. What would you like? Both competitors are ready. Audience members and camera crew, please stay still. Pre-memorization starts now. Simon wins with 44 words over Alex, 29. He now goes up 3-0. So for the fourth point,
Alex gets to choose. Cards, images, or names?
Cards.
Just to confirm, Alex and Simone, you'll be doing cards. The match is open. When you're ready, please indicate.
Pre-memorization starts now. Thank you. Alex Mullen wins. He comes back 3-1. Just a hair faster than Simon. They both got their decks right. Very nice. Simon's up 3-1. Simone, it's your turn. What would you like?
Images, names, or numbers?
Names.
Okay. Alex and Simone, just to confirm, you're doing names. The match is open.
names. That was good names. How'd you feel? How was that? You must be exhausted, right? Yeah, we're here. Yeah. It's crazy. Yeah, sure. Good. All right, so this final round, this final match will start off with the same surprise event that you saw previously with the textures, the tactile memory, and their match will be best of 9, so 1st to 5, and the fourth point will be another surprise event, something different that they haven't seen either. I'm sorry? Well, no, they know it's going to happen. So not, it's not a surprise. It is a surprise, but it's not a surprise.